Hey, it's Jackie Brawls.
Hey, everybody, this is Dunlap.
Well, say what, that's what we do. I say it, you make me wait every time, or you make a sound, or you open a, something up. Just I say my name, you say your name, and I do my sponsor. We never get through this with you go sign or whatever. If you don't want to be here, go on, leave.
Well, I took a big drink of this, and then, you know, sometimes when you drink, you get real thirsty, and you take too big a drink. And it takes a little bit out of you.
All right. Well, just don't drink.
And it takes you a second to catch your breath.
Drink before we start doing this, all right? That's all I'm saying is just do it before, and then you ain't got to worry about it when I start.
Okay.
Are you done? Make a noise. I'm going to do my sponsor.
I'm just, it's hot, Jackie. It's summertime. I get thirsty.
I know
thirsty.
It's hot. The sooner we get this over, the sooner we can get the hell out of here. You dragging it out. It's sweltering down here.
Oh, it is hot.
All
I will
right,
tell you
enough.
That. It is hot down here.
Well, let's get this over with, and then we can get out of here.
Yeah.
We do this every weekend. Let's do it. I said I'd do it till 100. I ain't doing no more after that.
It's episode 93.
Well, we're winding down. We won't have to be in here much longer. So I'm going to get this, just keep quiet, let me do it, get that.
Okay.
All right. Hey, it's Jackie, bro.
Hey.
No, I'm through. You already had your chance. I'm going now.
I thought we were starting over.
No, I'm Jackie Brawls.
You're so displeased.
I want to share my sponsor with all of you. I got a good sponsor. Y'all remember, everybody remember Miss Phillips Kitty Pillows. Not too long ago, Murfreesboro Museum did a what do you call it? A tribute, I guess. I don't.
An exhibit. They had
exhibit.
An exhibit.
Well, people looked at it as a tribute, I'd say, because
it's a tribute to a notorious cat killer.
Well, no, that was an incident, and they got sick. The cat died 2 or 3 years later, didn't kill it. The cat got sick from listen now. Anyway,
should we recap for people who may not?
Just
real quickly, Miss Phillips Kitty Pillows, many months ago, maybe a year, she come out with kitty pillows.
Had picture of a cat on it and the paint. She was selling it. And what people was doing is taking home for their cat and whatever kind of paint it was, whatever she did, the design cat got the cat sick.
Right, but they were kitty pillows because they had a picture of a cat on it. They were not for cats.
Not for cats.
They were toxic to cats.
Well, this is what she did. She felt horrible about that. Is anybody would make an animal sick? Nothing worse. Nothing make a person feel worse.
Nothing.
If you make an animal feel sick, you're responsible for an animal's well-being, and it gets sick on account of you. I, Lord knows it's happened. I've had pets over the years. Didn't want to, you know. But nothing makes you feel worse than
that. Wait. Didn't want to what? You had pets over the years. You didn't want to make them sick, and you did.
Accidentally, something fall in the. You don't do it on purpose.
Oh, like I remember Pepper.
Well, Pepper ate. Miss Brawls' pills fell on the ground. She got to take pills all day.
It's when she was first getting sick.
Well, that's what got that nurse at home looking after her till I get off work. So some of them pills fell off. Pepper, dog was old anyway, had Pepper for years. That was Miss Brawls' dog, wasn't my dog. I don't like little dogs. I mean, I liked Pepper, was fine. I liked it in the house. You know, it was fine. But Pepper ate some of them pills, got real sick.
Pulled through.
Well, yeah, I didn't say kill an animal. We
just
get people do that too by mistake. I mean, depending on what animal it is, if you run over cat, dog, jump out in the car, you ain't got time to swerve out of the way, that you feel awful. I didn't say kill an animal. I said make an animal real sick.
And Miss Phillips did make several cats.
Several cats. They pulled through. One of them died, but it was old. It was on its way out anyway. But anyhow, she felt terrible about that, so she made some new Miss Phillips kitty pillows, and those were for cats.
Right, they were just blue.
Well, yeah, you couldn't put that paint on it because a cat.
The paint was what was.
Well,
toxic.
Lick it or whatever. However, she did it. She painted a cat on it. It looked good. You saw one. It looked nice.
It looked good.
Looked like a little cat, little kitty cat. Now she still sold those, but just to people. She, you know, they said, "Oh, I want one of them pillows. They're cute." She would say, "Do you have any animals?" And if I said no, you know, Some, like I said, some people allergic to cats can't have them. Nice to have a little pillow with one on it.
So then the Murfreesboro Museum had a big exhibit about this because it was a big scandal
here.
Here
in Murfreesboro, now some, you know, smaller towns look for you know, things to happen. And this did, you know, did cause alarm in the town for a brief spell. Not long, but she was in the paper. And a veterinarian who saved these cats, he was in the paper. And so, you know, it was something that everybody knew about. And, yeah, I guess Murfreesboro Museum always looking for something, you know.
You know how local museums, like the Great Fire of 1962.
Yeah. So is they, anyhow, they did that. Now, see, because of all, she was ashamed of all this, regardless, some people still get mad. Like I said, she tried to change ways and get new pillows out, but she left town. But after this exhibit, like I said, it ended up coming out like a tribute because people said, oh, you know what, those pillows look good. She didn't know no better, bless her heart.
It's Act Two. It's America.
Yeah, you get a second chance. You know, that's how it works.
So this is Miss Phillips' Kitty Pillows Act Two.
Well, you could say that. Yeah, she's back, and she's a sponsor. And I tell you what, there ain't nothing buying or selling in this, but I won't tell you what she's doing. She has a big heart. We all know that. That's what I'm saying. That's the reason she made those blue pillows, because her heart broken about them cat getting sick. But she got a big heart, and she is, you know, we all know about the crisis on the border that Obama won't address, he won't fix. He thinks it's funny, all these poor children. People call them immigrants, this and that. They children. Before they can grow up knowing it better, they still children to me. So I don't know what to do, but you don't scream and holler at them. That's just my opinion on that. And that's Mrs. Phillips' opinion, too. So now she's making Mrs. Phillips' kitty pillows. Not kitty like kitty cat, but like kitty for children. Kitty pillows.
That's kitty.
That's what she's making.
K-I-D-D-I-E.
Yeah. And that's for these children. And she's made, I don't know how many. She got bags and bags of them. She's made so many of these. And she wants to get them down there, these children, because you see pictures. It's pitiful. They're sitting there. I hope Obama, you know, he take time to look at it. He won't go down there, but hopefully he's looking at a picture somewhere and see how pitiful they are, all these children. And they need pillows. I know people been sending them toys and this and that, but a pillow you need to lay down when you on a cold floor like that. You need a pillow. And many times I know, you know, having to go sleeping on concrete, I've done it before, and I wish I had a pillow. I took your jacket off, wadded up, put it underneath your head. But anyhow, these children need pillows. And what she's looking for is somebody that's got some time. Now, she's going to pay for gas money. She needs a big truck, a van, or a car with a trailer to drive these down to get these pillows, and they're adorable. They just nice. They got little pictures on all of them, and just the kids going to love it. And plus, they need to lay the head on it. So
what pictures on it?
It just got, you know, cats on it.
So it's kitty pillows with cats.
Well, just
on
cute, you know, that's all she know how to paint.
Oh,
good.
I see, the little, once you find what you're good at, you don't want to mess around with it.
Now,
too much.
She made some more. Now, granted, she had a lot of these laying around.
So see? These are some of the same pillows.
Well, they ain't cats coming across the border. It's children. And these pillows ain't going to hurt no human being. And these kids need to lay down. Need to lay the head on something, so, you know, now she made some new ones. Ain't all those. I don't know what kind of paint she used on the new ones, but, you know, she painted a cat pretty as on blue pillow. Got lots of them. Let's get them down there, these children. And like I said, she's going to pay for gas money. And she, I think, two meals on the way is what she said. Two meals and gas money to get down the border and give these children some relief on the heads when they lay down to sleep. Bless her hearts.
Are we certain these are not going to hurt these children?
They ain't no evidence of these pillows ever hurting these children. These children are hurt already after what they've gone through.
Now, I don't recall back as long as when Miss Phillips was a sponsor on here originally. I never went to the Murfreesboro Museum. I did stop by there to get some popcorn.
We got some popcorn running
when
there,
the exhibit was running. I didn't look it out, but wasn't there something, maybe this is a false memory.
Wow.
Wasn't some of the blue pillows, didn't they hurt people when they make it to people sick? I can't remember.
Well, these ain't just regular. I can't remember all of it. Now, when we went to the museum, all we looked at was that skeleton of the cat and got some popcorn.
Oh, that was awesome. It turns out it was an animatronic. It did move around.
I thought it was the real skeleton.
No, it may have been the real skeleton, but they did have it where you could press a button. It's like a children's museum.
Motorized, where,
yeah. Yeah, it's like interactive. So
Tail wag, this, that.
Yeah, and had two of them under there. You could make them fight. So that was cool.
We entertainment. That's all we looked at. I didn't see them move when I was there. I guess they wasn't time for to do a show.
Well, you were wrapped up in that popcorn, and I don't blame you.
I come over there and looked at it. I said, that's nice. He said, you want to look around the rest of it?
I was like, look at these buttons, and this 9-year-old kid made these cat skeletons fight, and that was worth the price of admission, which was free, but the popcorn was $1.50.
Well, I didn't need to look around. I lived it. You know, I saw it in the paper every day. I don't need to go read it again.
It was fairly recent.
Well, it wasn't too long ago, I guess, you know. But anyhow, bless your heart, Miss Phillips. New kitty pillars. Let's help her get them down. The boys, children, they're laying down. I ain't got nothing to put the little heads on. So let's get these pillars down there, these children. Get them in good health and get them feeling good before we send them back.
That's Miss Phillips.
Kitty pillars. K-I-D-D-I-E. Not kitty. I don't want people to get confused, even though we got cat on it.
Should she maybe test them out on some children here in Murfreesboro? Some sick report. I'm not trying to say take care. What about the white kids? I'm not trying to say that. I'm just saying if we send down a truckload of damn pillars that make a bunch of border kids sick,
they already sick after what they went through, so you can't pin that on. No, she ain't trying to make nobody sick.
I know she ain't trying to.
No, her heart's
in the right place. Big as the whole great outdoors.
Now, I don't want people out listening to this get the wrong idea and come help us haul them down there thinking, because there's some people don't like these children. They just plain don't like them. So we ain't sending nothing down there to hurt these children. Now, children, we're going to get them feeling good. Get them to the best health they can before we send them back home. Bless your heart.
Maybe you should go over there and get one of these pillows and rub it all over your body just to make sure. I'm saying, one, I don't want to hurt any kids. Two,
nobody's hurting no kids. They laying on the cold floor. They need something to put the head on is what I'm saying.
It's going to look real bad for us in Murfreesboro. We're going to look like some of them damn, like Sean Hannity in a boat with a gun.
No, I ain't. It ain't that.
Sean Hannity in a boat looks ridiculous, period.
Well, he don't look like he been on the sea. You know, he don't look like somebody be on a boat.
No, he looks like somebody in Popeye Town.
Well, he gets there, yeah.
If you put him in some stockings and he looks like somebody in Bluto's crew.
Yeah.
You give him a striped sweater that hangs down past his hands.
He one of them Asian people. Popeye hit him first. He go flying up in the air.
That'd be cool.
Well, anyway, I'm off. These pillars ain't going to hurt no children. They're to help the children, not to hurt, to help. So if you got a trailer, like I said, trailer van, anything, we can get all these bags of pillars in. And she going to pay for gas money and two meals on the way down there.
Gatos.
Huh?
Spanish for cat.
I am.
Jackie, I got a sponsor this week.
Well?
Peanut Pockets Restaurant.
Oh, yeah.
Since 1954, 60 years here in Murfreesboro. One of our longest-running establishments. Everybody loves Peanut Pockets Steakhouse.
It's like an establishment. I mean, this Murfreesboro has been here for years and years. Since I was out. You know, middle-aged young man that's been here, yeah.
Since you were a middle-aged young man. Yeah. Peanut Pockets Steakhouse here in Murfreesboro, just off the square.
Yeah.
They just wanted to give $25, let everybody know, you know, the year of their 60th anniversary is still ongoing.
Oh,
it's
coming up. Yeah. That's it, yeah.
They wanted to let everybody know that despite the recent troubles that they are open for business.
Now, why you won't bring it?
Well, they said they just need to let everybody know everything is fine. So that's Peanut Pocket Steakhouse.
Well, there was something going on down there. I will say yes. I don't know why I got to bring it up in the sponsor. Where you did, it was. I went down there to pull in. It's just chaos down there. I turned around and went out, and that went on for a few days. It was nasty down there. Just people, you know, people mad, people angry. So,
Maybe just quickly we should get into this so people know what we're talking about. Most people have been following the news here in Murfreesboro, so they know. Peanut Pocket Steakhouse has a mascot, of course, everybody's favorite restaurant mascot, Mr. Peanut Pocket. He's been around since they opened, basically, not long after. The first Peanut Pockets, Jackie's favorite, old McCleary Downsom.
Mr. McCleary Downsom, they've been good ones since him, like I said. They always one bad one, and he did not last long. He was out of there with a blink of an eye.
And we don't even want to say what he was in trouble for.
As soon as they caught wind of that, he was gone.
He was gone.
He didn't get it. But anyway, that's one out of how many now?
Right. My favorite was Dale Variety back in 80s to mid-90s.
He was good, too. Like I said, there ain't ever been one that I just didn't like. Fortunately for me, I never did go in there and see that because that was so fast. I never just saw his picture in the paper. That's all I saw. I didn't see him in the outfit or anything.
Sometimes they have celebrity Peanut Pocket appearances. We said last time they were a sponsor, we said that Ronnie Millsap, Leanne Rimes, Johnny Majors.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of different, that just for one night, they put on the Peanut Pockets outfit with those deep bulging pockets full of peanuts.
Just throw them all over the place.
Trumpet sounds, get out of the way or open wide.
Yeah.
That's what they say.
Yeah.
Get and out here come the peanuts.
Here they come. See, just throw them everywhere. Just
everywhere.
All over the place. I cover my food up is what I do.
Some people do that. I hear the horn.
I just get down, because when I get home, you shake your clothes loose, you got, there's a little bowl of peanuts you eat later. Yeah.
You can't tell if you having an affair with a Peanut Pockets waitress. Your wife going to know because they're going to be peanut shells.
Well, you don't have to put it that way, but there are peanuts everywhere. Ain't no you're going to get peanuts all over. You get in the hair. That's part of it. That's what the part of Peanut Pockets expands, and that's the reason it's been an institution in Murfreesboro for years. Yeah, but like I said, I always like the first. McLaren Dowson, he's my favorite. Mr. Peanut Pockets, but that was just because he was of my generation. It's not like the other ones are bad. They're fine.
It's not to your taste.
They throw peanuts just good, do all the sayings and, the dance, all that stuff. They do it fine.
Yeah, what people usually say is your favorite Peanut Pockets, Mr. Peanut Pockets, is the one, like when you were in junior high school, that. Yeah. Mine was Dale Variety, and he was around from Michael Jackson to just before Alanis Morissette. And that's my childhood.
Yeah. But everything's fine down there.
Everything's
now fine. Oh, good.
The recent, their most recent Mr. Peanuts pockets, the contortionist one, the one that could do the bend, he'd come out, throw some peanuts at you, and then he'd bend way, way back.
Yeah. And that's entertaining, yeah. I saw him a couple
times. And then he
could
sing that Eric Clapton real good.
Yeah? Is that who? That's who sings that song, right?
Yeah, Wonderful Tonight.
Well, you look wonderful tonight. He's singing that, you look good, and here's his peanuts in your face. I'll throw them at you, Wonderful Tonight, that's old Eric Clapton, yeah.
So, and that, of course, that was Andy Recorder. Everybody knows Andy. He's been there for a while. Well, I don't need to let you guys know that there's been some trouble here in Murfreesboro with the Sullivan-McKinley Wars.
It's getting awful, and there ain't no I don't even like bringing it up on here because I ain't got no opinion on the mannership. I ain't going to have nothing to do with any of them. But it's getting
Sullivan,
people up getting crazy over this.
Sullivan of Sullivan Auto Parts and McKinley of McKinley Air Conditioning have a feud. Because McKinley found a picture of Sullivan allegedly, with his hand on McKinley's sister Lynette's boob.
I don't want to hear all this.
While her wheelchair husband was in a wheelchair Olympics.
All right.
Now, Sullivan says that's not him. McKinley says that scar on your chin, because you can't really see his face, but you can see his chin and his hand on that boob.
All right,
and
enough.
Sullivan says that's not the scar on my chin. That's a fleck on the photograph or the film, or it happened in the development of the film.
All right, it's silly.
Two sides of the story. Then Jackie stirred things up when he said they were best friends.
I did no such thing. Listen to what you just said. That's the dumbest thing I ever heard. All this over that, the stupidest thing ever. People, all this mess. People riled up. And, they were fine. You know, Sullivan's auto parts, a fine establishment. McKinley had the washing machines. Everything's fine.
Air conditioning,
whatever it is. They just sell what you sell. That's it. They ain't in conflict. They're two different things. You can go to one and the other.
It's that boob picture.
I don't want to hear about it anymore.
So this town is torn asunder. People picking sides, putting
people
signs up in their yards. Sullivan, McKinley. I'm Team Sullivan. I'm Team McKinley. Last week, our good friend Jim Beavers, Comcast Cable, got run off the road by Sullivan, who did apologize.
Well, I didn't hear it from him. You apologized for him to me, and he ain't got to apologize to me on here. You go down the hospital, and you apologize to who you run off the road. Well, he's out of the hospital now. He ain't in there no more.
He just bumped his head, really.
Well, he's fine. He's doing all right.
I don't know if it's because of the world today with all the crises from the Ukraine to the damn border kids to Syria, fucking Syria.
All right, watch your mouth.
Goddamn.
Hey.
Egypt. To what am I forgetting?
Wait.
Shit in Iraq.
Yeah.
Holy hell. Ebola.
Ebola.
Kidnapping Africans. Taking the little girls.
Yeah. Pedophile. World is.
I run out of cuss words. I couldn't think of another cuss word for all the crises.
I'm at an age where I've seen a lot of horrible things happen in this world, but not all at once like this. The news don't even know what to talk about. There's so much stuff.
And then you see that. Everyone's on edge. Everyone feels this tension. And I just wonder if it's just affecting us everywhere.
I think that's what it is. I think people are just getting crazy.
So if Obama was doing a better job, I guess everybody would be.
That's you damn right. If he was taking care of stuff like he's supposed to do, that's what his job is. You president of the United States, you take care of stuff. That's your job.
So I'm just saying maybe Murfreesboro would not be about to boil over with, you know, Sullivan versus McKinley.
Well, there ain't no point, people. Like I said, there's enough bad stuff. You just went down the list going on in the world. Why you got to do something this stupid?
Well, so, okay, Andy Recorder, the most recent Peanut Pockets, Mr. Peanut Pockets, was out. He was singing as Eric. He was throwing peanuts. He was singing as Eric Clapton.
Yeah.
He was doing his contortions.
That's what he does. He does all those real good, yeah.
And then, all of a sudden, he stood up and said, well, I hope y'all enjoy your steaks, and I just want you to know I support McKinley. Oh, and about half the restaurant got up and left right then.
Well, tell them what she said.
Crunching their way to the door.
That's when I went down there. They're out there with signs.
Then there come the protests.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, you know, when people start coming to the restaurant protesting, you know who's got to take care of that, who does the crowd control is Mr. Peanut Pockets.
Yeah.
So he comes out there, he's like, look, y'all got to get out of here. I have I'm going to allow you to have your freedom of speech, but you know, people trying to eat, we need peace. And they're like, you know, Sullivan. And he started throwing peanuts at them, and you can watch a tape. He threw peanuts way too hard.
He did. I never seen anybody. Well, of course, you know, under the circumstances, you wouldn't throw them that hard inside the restaurant while people were eating. This is a different situation. He's out front. He's supposed to get these people, you know, to calm down, you know. It looked bad.
It looked good.
Never looks good when somebody throws peanuts that hard at somebody. That don't ever look good.
Way too hard.
Yeah.
And it was way over the top, and it was all over YouTube. And so that was it for Andy Recorder as Mr. Peanut Pockets.
He was a good one, too, yeah.
Yeah, it's really too bad. They had to bring in a new Mr. Peanut Pockets, somebody from the community, grew up around in the subdivision behind Peanut Pockets.
Yeah.
Who knew the area. Lester Speed Seat come in.
Yeah.
I think that's a stage name. I think about half of the Mr. Peanut Pockets take stage names.
It may be. I don't know entertainment business. That's what they do.
You know, if they have an ethnic sounding last name or something, they just want to appeal to all people who love steak.
Yeah.
They don't want a lot. Where are you from? So Lester Speed Seat is the new Mr. Peanut Pockets, and of course, here come people protesting the treatment that they got at the hands of the former Mr. Peanut Pockets. And things just getting out of hand, and he's like, "Look, I want to throw my peanuts. I want to let people eat their steaks.
That's part of what you go there for.
And
yeah.
I want to let you have your say in a peaceful manner. But we got to, a curfew, I guess you could call it. Like, y'all got to be out of here by 11.
Yeah.
So, because we got to roll silverware.
Well, you got to close up. Yeah.
You got to close up.
Well, you got to get ready for the next day. They don't sweep all the peanuts
it
up.
It takes all night to by 11 o'clock at night, you are up to your balls in peanut
shells.
Well,
yeah, it's like snowstorm or something. You got to wade through it. They leave some on the floor, but not like that. They get rid of more than half of it. Yeah.
One layer on the floor. They don't want less than an inch of peanuts and peanut shells on the floor. Very strict guidelines. They run a tight ship at Peanut Pockets.
Well, it's good. Like I said, it's
But known. They did not like that curfew, and the new Mr. Peanut Pockets, Lester Speed Seat, got to throwing peanuts, and he was throwing them way too hard, and
You think he would have learned from the last one?
Well, he said he was trying not. He said, "I was talking to everybody. I was walking with the protesters. I gave them some peanuts to throw. We were all throwing peanuts and talking and enjoying our freedom of speech." But by the end of the night, tensions had boiled over again. Everybody went home, but you just knew the next night something bad was going to happen.
Coming back. Is what the one they don't like is gone.
Well, you don't have freedom of speech one night only.
I know that, but they got mad. It was never all. It's not Peanut Pockets, the establishment. It was that one fella, the contortionist fella, playing a part.
Andy Recorder.
Now, he represents Peanut Pockets when he has that uniform.
Absolutely does.
It's not a uniform. It's like a clown. Something
costume,
like
really.
Costume, what it is. But when you have that on, you are representing. But what did they do? They fired him. They got him out of there.
They got Lester Speed Seat in.
But now, he did the same thing, and he shouldn't have. He should have learned from the last one.
And now it's getting worse because they have brought in the Peanut Pockets Patrol.
Wow.
So they've deputized a bunch of bus boys, and they got them outfitted in spare Peanut Pockets, Mr. Peanut Pockets costumes.
Wow.
And, they're like, tonight we're ready for them. They're like, we got military-grade peanut launchers.
What?
Combat-ready flak shells. Canisters of nut gas.
Well, you got to do what you got.
And tanks.
What? Tank?
They got tanks out there in front of Peanut Pocket. I don't know who'd want to try to go in there and eat, honestly.
Well, I'm just saying you got to do what you got to do in order for people to enjoy a nice meal. What's sad is they got all that outside. When you're inside eating, ain't nobody, all the Peanut Pockets outside, they ain't one in there to throw nothing at you.
Nope, you're in there with no peanuts.
Well, that's part of
you.
The fun of going. So I don't,
Well, you could go protest because you get plenty
I ain't going to protest. I wouldn't dare do that. That's something I don't do.
It's scary. Why would you even want to go inside when you got a line of the Peanut Pockets Patrol standing up there with their mirrored sunglasses on, their arms crossed, tough guys, scared to death. I wouldn't go in there. And then the new Peanut Pockets, they're like, well, he's supposed to be, from the community, Lester Speed Seat, and he he may be the scariest one of all because those bulging deep pockets full of peanuts that never end, It doesn't matter how many protesters show up. He's got a peanut with your name on it.
Same way inside. You said he's going to run out for too long.
No, he never does.
He never runs out. I don't know how to do it.
I don't either.
I mean,
they took some of that peanut throwing technology and they militarized it.
Well, under the circumstances, I don't know who's right or wrong in that situation. It's a mess. I understand why they need, they're your sponsor. They need to do whatever they can to get people
out. Well, Andy Recorder now, he's gone over to McKinley, and he's McKinley's personal peanut pockets.
Why do you got to be either one? It don't make no sense to me. That's all this mess. I went to go down there, like I said, I pulled in the parking lot, and it is just raining peanuts hitting the car, people screaming. It's the worst thing. I ain't going to get out and eat here. And it's all over foolishness. It's all over just the dumbest thing ever.
I'm just afraid McKinley, let alone what's happening at Peanut Pockets. But now McKinley has his very own cable installer.
What?
And his very own Mr. Peanut Pockets. I just wonder if that's too much power for one man.
I don't even know what to say about that.
I just don't like... Oh, I'm so thirsty. I just don't like the way... I know Sullivan runs Jim Beavers off the road, but now McKinley seems to be amassing these generals, I guess you could say. I don't know. It just seems like he is outclassing Sullivan strategically. I don't know how all this is going
to
end up.
It don't need to end up nohow. It's all crazy. People need to get the heads on straight. Why would you want to be on either side? I don't want to have nothing to do with nobody that mad for no reason. It's just silly.
Peanut Pockets is my sponsor this week. Telling you to come on in, everything.
Why would anybody go down there? Like I said, I know why they need
it. It's
fine. Wants to be a sponsor, but I mean...
Well, they give me $25.
Well, yeah, they got to do whatever they can. I mean, people ain't coming in there, you know.
Well, I was like, you got to meet me down at Dodge's because I ain't... coming in.
I wouldn't go near that. Normally you want to get peanuts thrown all
over
you.
Have you ever had a snoot full of nut gas?
What?
It's not a pleasant experience.
Nut gas?
Hey, look at there. You see him? Well, open your damn eyes then. It's the old-timey country down-home Red State Update podcast and them. Coming to you from a bunker underneath Jackie's Market in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. And here they are, both of them.
Hey, Jackie Bowles.
Hey, everyone. It's Dunlap.
Look, I want to get this...
Was my energy off?
What? I don't
pay. I thought you were mad at me for...
I don't care what you do. You do whatever. I'm going to go ahead and say my case.
Okay, I'm going to drink some of this beer.
Well, do whatever you want to do. I got something to say on here. Let me say it. Now, I see he's showing me what y'all was on the computer doing, and you do it on Bookface and all over Twitters, and, it's Flix on the TV.
Netflix is what you watch Rockford on, Granny.
But they ain't on there saying nothing about it. That's the point trying to get them.
No one is saying anything about us at all on Netflix.
Well, all right, but I don't know how all that stuff works. It's different things with different computers, different names.
That's true. Different computers, completely different.
Well, whatever you showed me. People saying this curse thing now.
The curse, the Red State Update podcast curse.
It ain't no such thing as a curse. Say it right now. I don't like people saying affiliating me with any kind of magic or dark stuff. It's silly. I don't have nothing to do with it. There ain't no such thing as curses. Now, it's pitiful what's been happening. You did point out to me that there is, what'd you call, coincidence?
Let me give you some facts, Jackie, and then you tell me there's no curse.
Oh, come on.
Jackie, first of all, the curse is mentioned on our Wikipedia page.
I don't even know what that is. I don't get on it.
So it must be real. Or at least
crowdsourced.
Or
in our case, one particular guy sourced. Let me give you some facts here. Mickey Rooney, we discussed him on our podcast that was uploaded on March 31st. Mr. Rooney passed away on April 6th.
He died, yeah, but...
James Garner, we discussed him on our podcast that was uploaded June 2nd. He passed away on July 19th.
All right, that's still like...
Robin Williams, Master of Mirth, beloved comedian and actor, was discussed on our podcast on July 14th and July 21st. We were mainly talking about my Mark cards.
Well, yeah.
But then Jackie said something, which in retrospect sounds like an asshole thing to say. He said Robin Williams made him nervous.
That ain't nothing. When he's on, listen now.
And I guess he made him so nervous.
No.
He killed him.
I did.
With the curse.
Do no.
On August 11th.
Such thing. Listen now. When I said he makes me nervous, that's when he's on talk shows. Talking to Johnny Carson, whoever, he makes me nervous. He moves around so much. Now, in movies, he's good. I feel terrible for him and his family. I won't say that now. I ain't got nothing bad to say about the man. I know people love him to death. Flubber and what's the one, the football one? He's in with Tombstone. The football movie.
Best of Times?
That's a good movie. I like him in that. He got on glasses. He acting regular. And he's a good actor. And I know people liked him and laughed at him, and that's fine. Just wasn't my cup of tea when he's on talk show. Didn't say nothing bad about him. There's a lot of good movies he made. Children like Flubber. That's what I mean. He made thing for Flubber, for children. That's Walt Disney. Children like that, and then Jonesy. Jonesy with all the animals in it. I watched that because somebody said there'd be animals in it that look right. Jonesy is good for children.
Animals didn't look right in Jonesy. It's that. No, but we had did not have Andy Serkis. We did not have motion captured down quite right. I think if you go back and take a look at Jonesy, you'll see that those animals do not look right. But that's not Robin Williams' fault.
No, he didn't have nothing to do. He was fine in it. That's what point I'm saying. These are movies, like he made a movie for children, he made a movie for grown-ups, football movie. He was a good actor, and I'm sorry. It's terrible what happened. I feel terrible about it. I just don't. He ain't my cup of tea when he's talking to somebody else running all over the place. I can't handle that here in the store, let alone on TV.
Did he ever come in the store?
No, he didn't come in the store. I didn't mean that. I'm just saying. It makes me nervous when somebody behaves in that manner. I know he's funny. And I like him. You know, in movies, he did things.
I do want to say that Jackie was a little... I mean, you were kind of depressed this week. You kept telling me to come over and put Best of Times on the flicks.
I like Best of Times on flicks. It's just sad, you know, somebody brings so much joy to everybody. Besides, you know, interviews for me on TV. Kids liked him. People liked him. He was, you know, it's just sad when that sort of thing happened. Yeah, it's always sad, yeah.
And my Mork and Mindy cards.
I didn't like Mork and Mindy. He was running around on that one. Nothing wrong with him. He's a fine, talented gentleman. Just not my cup of tea.
When I thought they might go up in value, but I wasn't going to sell them because Robin Williams meant a lot to me. I would sell them if they went up a lot in value. They did. Price kind of stayed the same, I'm going to be honest. And I don't have a complete set. I've only got the four.
Well, who's to say? You just said I said something and killed him. You could have said something. Your curse is on you, too. It ain't just me. I ain't Red Staggy Up. Like my name's Jackie Broads. Both of us said that. You could have tried to kill him with your curse because you wanted them cards money.
We're getting a lot of people saying, don't mention my name on the podcast. We did have several people mention this curse to us. Mentioned it on.
Ain't no such thing. I'm just making a point. You didn't kill nobody. I didn't kill nobody. It's just questioning.
Now we're getting requests to not mention people on the podcast, and then we're getting requests. People do want us to mention some people.
No,
I don't know how to use this power. I mean, it seems to me
we've been saying Obama on here every time we talk about McCain. All them, they still living.
It must not work on political figures. It must only work on entertainment.
Now listen, I say this with all due respect. Jane Garner and Macarona had one foot in the grave. Age up there in age.
Most of our references are elderly.
And then, oh, Robin Williams, funny, that's just tragic as hell. That's just awful what happened there. So, I mean, that nobody foresaw that coming. But there's two people who you knew would die in a minute. They was up there in age. That's what happens. We get old, we die.
But we have talked about a lot. We've talked about Hee Haw several times. We talked a lot about a lot of entertainment people. They are not dead. I mean, the only ones we mentioned.
On Hee Haw. Don't want no more die on there.
Now, had we mentioned George Jones on the podcast before he passed away, well, we would have had to.
That wasn't a situation. He's up there in age. Bless his heart.
But I don't feel that. When George Jones dies, I don't think anyone is responsible except for about 30 years of living.
Well, yeah. That's all there is to it, yeah. Same could have been for Mick Rohn, James Garner. Who knows?
Yeah, Mickey Rooney was 90. Well, how old was he? Like 90 years old. So I don't think that's a curse. But
no.
We could test it out. Maybe it only works on old people. Maybe it's sort of a mercy curse. It's like a Kevorkian curse.
There ain't no such thing as just talking about something and somebody dying. I don't appreciate that. I don't like it. I don't want people out there saying that. I don't want to have nothing to do with nothing. I don't want to be affiliated, no curse, witches, devil stuff. I never have like that stuff. I don't like it. I know it ain't real. It ain't real, but I still don't like it.
So, like, if you come into your house and you seen a bunch of devil worshipers in robes with their hoods pulled up, and they had a big pentagram carved into your kitchen floor, and they had, like, sheep's blood poured
all
in it,
right,
and it was boiling up. And,
enough.
And would you say, get out of here, that ain't real? Or would you be scared and put your house on the market?
I'd run them the hell out is what I'd do. Anybody in there doing foolishness like that, I'd get the hell out of my damn house.
I don't care
who you are.
That sounds like the best damn 70s redneck/horror movie. Jackie Brawls versus devil worshippers.
Oh, I don't.
No, listen to this. Imagine that, like, damn old Buford Pusser comes home, and instead of having trouble with the redneck mafia, he has trouble with a bunch of devil worshippers.
What? I ain't going to be in nothing like that.
It's like Death Wish 3 in the South with devil worshippers.
Oh, enough.
That's a good movie.
I don't want to see no movie. Don't want to be have no movie and devils in it. I don't like exorcists, omens. I don't like any of that stuff. It ain't my cup of tea. Don't like it. I know people like it, and I probably like it for the wrong reasons.
Folks, if you want to see that movie,
why
don't you let us know?
What movie?
The Jackie Brawls versus the devil worshippers.
Oh, I ain't gonna have nothing to do with that.
We'll make it ourselves. We'll put it up online for people to watch. Jackie boot kicking a bunch of devil worshippers.
Well, I wouldn't be boot kicking them.
I think you would be.
I'd have a shotgun up the back and running them out. I wouldn't shoot them if I didn't have to.
It'd be like House of the Devil.
I'd make them clean up all that blood for the left, too. I say clean that mess up, blow them candles out, clean that up, and get the hell out. I wouldn't have them in my house, but I don't care about no movie. That's real life. If I saw something like that, wouldn't have it.
See, this writes itself.
Oh, hell.
What were we talking about? The curse.
Hey, there ain't no curse.
Of
that's
the Red
point.
State Update podcast.
There ain't no curse.
So, let's see who dies next.
Oh, well, now see, it's in the back of your head. I know it's a bunch of bull, but now I feel like if I say anybody's name.
Let's just start naming some people and
no,
see what happens.
No, I don't want no one to die. You can say whatever, they ain't going to die anyway. But now that you put it out there, it seems like if something happened to somebody, then that's pitiful.
Yeah, I don't want anybody to die.
No, I don't want to have nothing to do with nobody dying. I like Mickey Rooney, James Garner, and I like Runways in the Best Times movies.
Do you like Valerie Bertinelli?
Who?
It's just a test.
I don't know who
I have
is.
No ill will towards her, but I feel like we need to test this out. So I'm just going to leave that line there.
Don't do that. Well, if she's,
that's it.
If she's,
I'm not going to mention it again. I'm just... It's a test.
If she's fine, And next, it's...
We give it like a month.
There ain't no
month and a half.
All right. There ain't no such thing as that. I don't appreciate people saying that.
But if we have that power, Jackie, I need to know because I can use it to my advantage. Financially and sexually.
Oh, come on. There ain't no power. There ain't nothing like it. It ain't real.
Well, we'll see.
We ain't going to see. I don't even know who Burton is.
Don't push it.
Well, I don't know who it is. I don't feel bad by saying if I don't know who the hell it is.
We're just
who is it?
Leave it laying.
Who
there.
Is it? One, I don't know one, who it is. If one, something happens to her, I don't want to wait and see one, a picture on her.
One day at a time.
One day at a time. Oh, Snyder.
Nope. He's not still
him.
Alive.
He's
no, don't kill Snyder.
I didn't say his real name. I said his name on the show. He's been dead on the show many years.
Did he so die on the show?
I don't know. It ain't on TV.
Pat Harrington is still alive, and I don't want to be responsible for his death.
Well, don't say his name. I didn't know
who
I don't
want to be responsible for Valerie Bertinelli's death either.
Which one? I don't even know which one she
was
the
little one.
The little one.
The youngest daughter married Eddie Van Halen.
Who? Halen?
So let's just hope and pray. See, now I thought it'd be a very simple test. I said one name. Now you've already polluted it. Now there's two names out. Now something could happen to both of them. People say it's a one day at a time. Damn.
What?
Curse. Instead of the Red State Update curse. And then one day at a time gets the credit for our curse.
What? I don't want no one to die on there.
I don't want anyone to die
see,
either.
People say the TV show got cursed all the time like a Death of Strokes, all of them dead.
No, don't.
Well, they dead. I can say it already. He dead. The little one fella dead. Him and the rest of them all dead, ain't they?
I don't. They may all be dead. I don't know. I'd have to look it up. Okay, that's probably okay because I do think they're all dead.
Well, they passed on. And you can say there's no. You see, you got me all worked up in this. I can say whatever the hell I want. There ain't no such thing as a curse. You say that, it gets in the back of my head, and then it bothers me. And I don't want to say nobody's name, except Dave Stokes, who say everybody on there, they all dead.
Bonnie Franklin's already dead, too.
Who?
Bonnie Franklin already dead.
I don't
dead.
Know who. I don't
she was
know.
A mother on
Oh, little
time.
Redhead, little yeah. Spitfire redhead. Yeah, she was good. That's hard. Sorry to hear that.
Mackenzie Phillips still alive, though.
Who?
Never mind. Listen, I'm not going to name everybody on the damn show.
Well, don't. Don't do it, because I don't want no one.
I don't want anybody
no one's going. Nothing's going to happen. Listen, it don't
Can
matter.
Can we
nothing.
Not?
But then when you say somebody's name, people think you want something to happen.
I do not. Let's go on record right now. I do not want Valerie Bertinelli, Mackenzie Phillips, or especially Pat Harrington.
I don't want none of them.
To die.
No, of course not. And the different strokes, I wish they weren't dead.
Ooh, what if we could resurrect people? What if we had that power?
Oh, come on, enough.
Todd Bridges? He's got to be alive.
Who?
Todd Bridges?
I don't know all these names.
What about Dudley?
Who?
Dudley?
Oh, on different strokes, Dudley. Like I said, I wish all of them was alive. I'm sorry they passed on.
I wish they were all alive doing a big one day at a time, different strokes crossover episode.
Well, I don't know if that'd work.
But it ain't going to happen. We're going to have to just see if anybody... Oh, I looked this up on my phone, Jackie. This is a very good... This ties it all together. Todd Bridges. Todd Bridges apologizes, Jackie. This is on allhiphop.com because that's where you go when you want to learn about Todd Bridges.
What?
Todd Bridges apologizes for calling Robin Williams' suicide very selfish.
He shouldn't have said that.
I heard people saying that. I know Rush Limbaugh kind of came down on Robin Williams.
Well, people like him look for something. That's what they get paid for, to say awful stuff. People are like, oh, my goodness, I can't believe he said this. That's what he does. He says awful. We all covered this. That's
Todd
what,
Bridges?
No, not Todd Bridges. I don't even know what he does nowadays. I couldn't tell you. Which he's a older brother on there, right? Figure
yeah, I guess he didn't.
He's still alive.
I heard a lot of people get in trouble for saying selfish, depression, kill yourself is selfish. And then, but I did not hear that Todd Bridges said it too, which has to be, I mean, you're going to go out on a limb and then nobody even pays attention. Well, all hip hop covered it, so I guess that's something.
Well, he shouldn't have said that. That's, you know, we got to keep in mind people's family.
But he did apologize. So Todd Bridges doing okay.
Well, good. I'm glad.
But I do think Kimberly, Mr. Drummond, Arnold all passed away.
Yeah, bless your souls.
So now, I guess if anything happens to Rush Limbaugh, see, I can't even keep track. Rush Limbaugh, any surviving members of One Day at a Time, or Different Strokes, if anything happens to them in the next month and a half, 2 months, then I guess the curse is real.
Ain't nothing going to happen to them. Nothing's going to happen to them. Don't say that. Everybody's going to be fine. Well, I just, y'all quit putting foolishness on. I don't even look at it till he shows it to me. Don't put none of that on the computers, Flex, or anywhere. I don't want to see none of it.
Does Rush Limbaugh count as a political figure or an entertainment figure? I think he's
on the radio. He ain't a politician. He's on the radio. That's entertainment.
But we talk about a lot of politics people, and they don't die.
No,
so
they
the
don't.
Curse is seems to be strictly entertainment. Which has the best theme song, One Day at a Time or Different Strokes?
Yeah, both.
Well, both
I
pretty
remember,
good. Both
I
pretty
remember
good.
Being good. One Day at a Time. Yeah, it's good. And then,
so up on your feet.
Up on your feet. Well, that music's playing. Yeah.
Ain't no worry you. And that can't last all it comes one day at a time.
Yeah, that's good. And Different Strokes.
Now,
you come back to me.
World don't move. To the beat of
just one drum.
It might be right for you,
but it's not right for some.
A man is born. He's a man of means.
Means, yeah. That's drum. That's talking about Miss Drummond.
Uh-huh.
That, yeah. Tell a story.
Then along come two. They got
nothing but the dreams.
Jeans.
Was
it dreams?
I don't know.
Wait, I thought it was jeans. But actually, now that you say it, it may be dreams.
There ain't no high listening.
Oh, longhorns.
Can you hear it? His nope. Tails go crazy. I don't know if it's longhorns. Or,
no, it used to
it
be.
It could be. Now, you always knew. But now you hear it. It's shoving them.
McKinley
mess. It's stupid.
Used to people would get in a fight over drug deal gone bad.
All right.
Getting in a fight over some pussy.
Hey, I'm not going to hear that.
Getting a fight over
language.
Some dumb, somebody get drunk, say some, throw off some dumb ass insult, lure people. Now it's Sullivan McKinley. That's what people fight over.
Man.
Which, granted, it did kind of start. Round one was because of the picture on the hand on
all
the boot.
All right. There ain't no reason to bring it up again. It's a bunch of foolishness and people are
but
crazy.
But then Jackie just added fuel
I
to the fire.
I did no such thing. If they think that crazy, all this crazy, why is anybody get worked up over any of this? It don't make no sense to me. The world's gone crazy. The world's bad enough without curses. You ought not say stuff like that. We don't need curses. Not true. None of that's magic. None of that's real.
But they got Different Strokes. They got
Different Strokes. They got
tanks.
Different Strokes. Yeah, I remember that. I like it. It was funny. That show was funny. And one day, I liked them both. I don't know which one I like better than the other.
I can't remember. One Day at a Time, they lived in an apartment. Was it a good apartment?
Well, Snyder was a man that fixed things, so yeah.
Did he have a job?
He was a janitor or whatever.
No, or did
super,
she have a job?
What do you call it? I don't know if she worked. I can't remember where she worked. I know girls get in trouble, and she set them straight. The same on Different Strokes. It's just, you know, two little boys.
Yep.
And a girl.
And a girl.
Yeah.
Everybody's got a different kind of story. Everybody finds a way to shine.
Huh?
It don't matter that you got not a lot. So what?
Yeah.
They'll have theirs and you'll have yours
yeah.
And I'll have mine.
Yeah, that's the end of it.
And together we'll be fine because it takes.
Different Strokes, yeah.
It takes.
Different Strokes, yeah.
It takes.
Different Strokes in the world, yeah. I always like Cheers, too.
That's a
one.
Good one. So...
What's wrong with you?
I'm just looking at all hip hop.
What is?
Well, they got all these Todd Bridges things on here.
Well, is that what he does now? What is on you? He's on your phone.
I cannot
understand.
Find any Todd Bridges news except on allhiphop.com.
Well, that's what it does now, I guess. I don't know. I'm glad he's still with us. I'll say that, even if you say this thing you're not supposed to. But like you said it's sorry. Be glad you's live. Don't be talking about that. If you ain't got nothing to say good about somebody, don't say nothing at all. Especially when they passed on like that. Pedal.
I'm going to go to his Twitter right now.
Huh?
And follow Todd Bridges on Twitter. Because I don't want to be left in the dark like that the next time he says something.
Why?
I mean, I want to be on top of things.
Well, if he's going to say things like that, I don't want him to say things. If he have to say something, say he's sorry the next day. Of course, that's everybody on the computer now. Everybody says something, and then the guy say they're sorry.
16,000 followers.
Huh? Followers?
He has 16,000 people follow him on damn Twitter.
Yeah, so different strokes, Bridges.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They won't let me.
I don't know what you mean, followers. I don't know where, how to look at it on computer, right?
It won't let me view his tweets. He must have got in trouble.
Well, he did. He just said he had to apologize. He still run his mouth.
We can go to Loney Love's Twitter.
Who?
Listen. I guess we need to talk a little bit about Missouri.
Pitiful.
Ferguson.
Pitiful what's going on, yeah.
It does seem like the militarization of the police did seem, aside from the racial overtones, it did seem like a lot of people, whether they were racist or not, could agree that maybe the cops shouldn't have all those weapons. Not everybody agrees with that, but I did notice that, like, Don Podge of Tax Whiz, Master of Disguise.
He's upset.
Freedom Fighter. He's like, I have been telling you, we were at Bundy Ranch saying this same stuff.
Right.
Now, a lot of people at Bundy Ranch haven't really been. I tried to show them this, and they were like, ah. But
you didn't get caught up in it.
They didn't. They have. Well, they've got their own.
They got their own business going on. Yeah.
But he did say that some people there were upset by the police activity, and you know, old Rand Paul, come out and he. I don't know what Rand Paul is doing, Jackie.
I'm telling you something ain't right when the only one making sense is Rand Paul on stuff. It don't make no sense to me. Something ain't right. The world ain't right. And all these people, I used to say they's crazy. I say, you know, nothing against Don Pods. I ain't talking about him personally, but some of his clients getting upset. You know, we need guns and this. And you know what? You need a gun. You don't need a whole artillery and this and that. But then after this happened, you just made all those people, you just give them something. What do they say all the time? False flags.
Yep, false flag. You think this is a false flag
No,
operation?
I don't. I don't think none of it is. They say stuff like this because they say government's trying to do this and that, so I wonder what they're saying about this.
Oh, because the government usually uses it as an excuse to take your guns away, these false flags.
Yeah.
This seems like a false flag.
In the other direction.
A reverse false flag.
Well.
I can't keep up.
I can't either. I don't know. It's everybody going crazy right now. It's all different groups. Yes, Tea Party takes it too far sometimes. Then it was that on Wall Street? What is that?
The Occupy Wall Street?
Yeah, they on the other end, they go too far. Everybody going crazy. Now, I ain't saying that about Ferguson. I'm just saying in general, everybody's losing their minds. Now, Ferguson, if that's what happened, that's pitiful what happened. If they shot some boy for no reason, if he was unarmed and... I'm not saying all this should happen, but I don't know. I don't know anymore.
Rand Paul comes out and he says that he writes a article in Time Magazine saying, you know, take these guns. Cops don't need these military weapons.
I don't see why anybody needs a tank.
Well, look, Jackie, here's what it is. I mean, you come down, everybody gets mad at the police in this situation for shooting a
black one, kid. Sure.
That's step one.
That's one policeman who did that, and if that comes out to be true, and he ought to, you know.
But then it goes further from that when they start overreacting, and it's sort of like.
Now, who's overreacting?
The police are overreacting.
Well,
when the police start.
Some people say. That, you know, Sharpton and Jesse Jackson get down there and get everybody riled up. That's what they say. They take the opportunity to make people mad. Now, they already have reason enough to be mad if this man is shooting people. If a policeman's shooting people, well, unarmed, and they got reason to be mad. But it seems like, I'm just saying, you look at two ways.
What are the two ways?
Well, one way the police overreact, and then the other way some of the people overreact. If the people break in, tear up stores and stuff like that.
Well, stores. Look, I've been under the gaze of some police officers for a long time.
Yeah, that's true.
I have many enemies on the Murfreesboro police force.
Yep, they don't like you.
Some of these feuds go back to elementary school.
Yeah.
Some of them, remember you used to have to pee in the trough?
Wow. Huh.
Remember you have to, used to back in the 70s, I don't know if kids remember this, you have to go to like see a concert in like the worst venue. But they just got a trough where you pull your dick out and you piss in that thing.
All right.
And then, I used to just make fun of everybody else's dicks.
What?
I just knew, it's like when you go to prison.
I don't want
to
hear
and you have to hit the biggest guy in the face with your fist. It's when you go to elementary school, you got to make fun of everybody's dicks. First day.
I don't want to hear any of
this. And then they say, well, this is somebody not to mess with. Because I'll be like, what's the matter with your dick?
Hey.
Well, some of these people have gone on to become police officers. Possibly because of what I said.
What?
And now they rule the streets, and they think they can push me around, and they're so smart. Really? Third marriage?
What?
Who's smart now? I'm on zero marriages.
What?
I'm talking to Bobby. Officer Bobby. And your weird-looking dick.
Can I see?
F
enough.
You.
I'm not going to listen to that.
Come get me.
You sitting here trying to start stuff up.
That's the point.
So if you know.
But I have a right to freedom of speech.
You do. Everybody has every reason to protest.
I have a right to protest.
Now listen. Now, I didn't say they shouldn't be there. I'm just saying some people say that. People got every reason to be upset. If that comes out to be what happened, I'd be in the streets too, hollering and screaming.
Look, it's bad what happened.
Yeah.
Whatever they find out. Horrible.
Yeah.
We do not. You can just shoot. I mean, how many?
You can't shoot people for. Now, look, I had some people come in my store and steal a box of cigars before.
Uh-huh.
I've had it happen.
I've done it.
I know. Well, I took my shoe off, knock them in the back of the head, knock them down, go out there and pick my cigars, put them back in the box.
And then the cycle continues next day.
Well, no, not every day. It don't happen. I'd got you a couple of times, but I'm just saying. I never pulled a weapon. Wouldn't think about pulling a weapon on nobody.
I don't even smoke cigars.
Well, I don't know why you're taking them in.
Fun.
Well, that's what come out. Please put that out, and then they say, well, the man that shot him didn't know nothing about it. So that don't make no sense to me. I don't understand.
Cops have mishandled this. Cops are full of shit.
Well, what the dead wrong? Well, they did a lot of stuff wrong, reckon. But
yeah,
I don't know. Starting
with step one is shooting that kid.
Well, we're all in agreement there. That is, if that comes out to be the case, then yes, should not be doing it. Like I said, people steal a cigar, I ain't gonna throw it. But I don't understand how come. They put that on TV, he's stealing cigars, but then they say the policeman didn't know. I don't know what it got to do with it. Anyway, if he shot somebody, then he needs to suffer the consequences. Now, when they also messed up after that, It just got worse, is what I'm saying. It was mistake after mistake. We made the biggest mistake out the gate.
Right.
And then let's just keep
made it
making,
worse
making more. Now, some people shouldn't have been breaking in, looting this and that. They ain't supposed to do it. I understand people upset, but you can't, you know. And then
look,
they took the people, the reporters, now they messed up bad then. If you tell a reporter something to stick it or put that camera up, what do you think they're going to say about you?
They're going to report it.
They're going to say what
you did.
If you were mean to them, yeah. So why did they do that knowing what was going to happen? The reporter's the worst person you can be smart with.
Now, tensions are still high there, but since they got rid of that first bunch of cops of their duty, things have simmered down momentarily.
Well, they were tired. They wore out.
They just brought in? I thought it was more like a Barney Fife thing, like Barney Fife is in control of this situation. Like, let's imagine in Mayberry, Barney Fife shoots an unarmed black teenager.
He shoots his foot all the time. Who knows?
Who knows what he's going to do?
He got that one bullet.
He's got the one bullet.
So
if Barney Fife had access to all these military-grade weaponry, and people were like, why'd you shoot that unarmed black teenager? He would start firing tear gas at them immediately.
He'd be terrified. Oh, you know, Barney Fife be shaking, scared to death. Well, that's what I got to do. I'm in charge. You know how he
always told. Andy's on vacation in Mount Pilot. He has to come. They bring him in to clean up the mess.
Yeah.
But by then, it's too late.
It's too late.
By then, it may be too late for even Andy Griffith to get things under control.
And he's the best one at it.
Why would you leave Barney Fife in control for even a second? That's Andy's fault.
Well, he messed up, yeah. You take it to the top. You got to say he's the one, you know, put Barney in charge.
See, that's exactly right, Jackie. Now, I hate cops.
Hey, not all cops. See, that you just as bad as saying all police kill people. They don't. Some of them, bad ones, I guess, do.
Some of them just beat people.
Well, some of them do.
I've had run-ins with cops where they are like, hey, your windows are tinted too dark. And then I say something simple like, fuck you.
Hey.
And then I'm on the ground. I have a right to express myself.
No, you don't.
Okay, what about that time when he was like, let me see your license and registration. I started going through Granny's glove box and said, I hope I ain't no guns in here.
Why?
On the ground.
I know.
There wasn't no guns in there. I'm not that I'm not an idiot.
All right. You are an idiot.
Cops. But say everybody's so mad at the cops. All the liberals mad at cops. All the libertarians mad at cops. Everybody gets mad at cops. Like, oh, cops killed a kid and they keep the race. You know what? The cops are just part of the system that we all live in.
Well, it they are. Yeah.
We set it up. We got all the minorities and we keep them all boxed in, and all the poor people, we keep them in the poverty and shitty schools and the drug wars and the prison for profits. And it's been like this for years and years. It started on slave ships.
Wow.
Slave ships.
Slave ships.
There were more slave ships, Jackie, than one would dream of.
Well, yeah, it's terrible history, yeah.
I forgot the rest of it.
Wow.
Face in your face, not an 8-track.
You say racist stuff, which, you know, it looks, you know, police ain't supposed to be racist. Let's say, first off, even though, you know, people get fired for being in the Klan, this and they find out too late sometimes. But anyways, when you look on TV and see this, you see a bunch of white policemen shooting tear gas on black people. It's got bad memories to it. Bad things happen, you know.
It's exactly why people think everybody in the South is an idiot, because they remember the 60s and like, you know, most dogs are friendly. I don't know what happened there in their accent.
Yep. Bad things happen.
Who's going to get hurt by a little hose? Luckily, Missouri don't have that strong of a Southern accent. It's kind of a blend Midwestern. Anyway, what I'm saying is that these cops, we use these cops. I'm saying we're getting mad at the henchmen.
Why?
We're getting mad at the supervillain. Get mad at the person in charge.
Supervillain.
Get mad at, okay, look at it like this. Get mad at Lex Luthor. Lex Luthor. Get mad at Darkseid. Okay, let's see. Like, okay, we live on Apocalypse. What? And we're like, boy, that Desaad is really getting out of control. We need to prosecute Kalibak. What about fucking Darkseid?
Hey, watch your mouth.
The fact that you are a citizen of Apocalypse? Are you not culpable at all? It's a shame what them parademons did, but what? I work at West Apocalypse Target. I don't see how I'm to blame. Okay, I don't really know who Desaad or Kalibak is. All that Jack Kirby stuff.
I don't know none of that is. You got to explain it some way. I understand.
I don't know.
I know Lex Luthor.
Lex Luthor, okay, forget Darkseid.
I don't know
That's
who
good.
That is. Lex
I
Luthor.
Can't keep all them new gods. You got to be really high.
Lex Luthor, bald-headed, Superman.
Yes, okay, let's say Lex Luthor gets elected mayor of Metropolis.
Well,
he might be mayor of Metropolis right now in the comic books. As bad as racism is, New 52 is much worse.
What?
Lex Luthor's running Metropolis, and we know, okay, just right there, you know, there's some shady shit going on. You know, he got Superman in a kryptonite cage on top of the Daily Planet clock tower or whatever.
That's what he likes, yeah. He wants to do that.
Yeah, yeah. Superman writhing.
Hurts him.
But, you know, we live in Metropolis. We got cable. We got Starbucks. We got a Lois Lane apartment penthouse.
Wow.
You know, we go to that good restaurant with the fish.
Fish?
Famous Metropolis fit. We turn a blind eye. Then let's say that Otis kills a black teenager. And it blows up on YouTube.
Otis in Superman's. Otis, he's got that music.
And then everybody would, exactly, Jackie, we'd get mad at Otis. Otis is an idiot. He got a damn bassoon and tuba playing when he walks down the street.
Yeah.
Yeah, fire Otis. Put Otis in jail. Anonymous, look up Otis's last name, sure. But can we not assume that the problem goes deeper than Otis with his hat and his military-grade weaponry? Fuck Otis.
Hey.
Fine, fuck him. Fuck the cops, but don't stop there. What about Lex fucking Luthor? And what about the people who elected Lex Luthor to be mayor of Metropolis, Jackie? What about you and me?
Well, Lex Luthor, what are you going to do? You get rid of Otis, he's just going to get a new Otis.
And then there'll be another Otis after that.
Well, yeah.
We got to make some major changes here. Just don't get mad at Otis. Everybody, we should just let Zod terraform us.
Why?
I'm mixing cinematic and pre-New 52
I don't
universes,
know what
but my
that
point
is.
Stands.
I don't know what none of
I'm
it
just
is.
Saying, get mad at Otis, but don't forget what's behind Otis.
Yeah, that's Lex Luthor's.
Lex Luthor, yeah. But don't forget...
Now, who
the
is
the corrupt racist system that has installed Lex Luthor?
Why?
Atop. It started on slave ships. Slave ships.
What? I don't know.
There are more records of slave ships than one would dream.
What?
God, I cannot remember that next part.
I don't know what you're saying.
Anyway, Rand Paul's going to ride this anti-cop stuff. He's hanging out with Cory Booker. Do you think Rand Paul, is there a chance, Jackie, that Rand Paul could win?
I don't think a little weasel going to be elected president, and that's what he comes off to me as. I don't know.
It's kind of smart what he's doing, but he's still a weasel.
If we end up with Hillary and Bush again... Although, you know, Jeb should get a chance. He ain't going to be as good as, you know.
No, old Mushface. Yeah, Mushface versus Weasel. Is that what it's going to come down to?
I don't know. People may just be sick of the same damn thing over and over again. Why not do it? I ain't going to vote for him.
Like, if Rand Paul, I mean, he can start talking being anti-cop, anti-drug wars, anti-overseas wars.
Yeah. He don't like none of it, yeah. But, well, that's Obama. Obama ain't doing nothing. He just started to get back in Iraq. Obama don't, the world's falling apart, and he's just sitting back on vacation.
Playing golf. I saw people saying that we should stop making fun of presidents when they go on vacation. I saw that. People say we made fun of Bush. We made fun of Obama. Each side makes fun of Everest, Clinton, Daddy Bush always say, oh, he's off on vacation. And they all go on vacation.
They all do it, yeah.
They're all on call. Yeah. Being president doesn't stop just because you're on the golf course.
Well, come on now. This is pretty, there's a lot going on right now. There's a lot going on.
This is probably the most going on ever.
Ever. So why you want to take vacation during that? I don't understand. And I tell you something else. Black people are not mad or mad at Obama right now, besides good Dr. Ben Carson. There's other people mad because this Ferguson thing. He ain't, you know.
He ain't said nothing about Ferguson.
Well, he said something about it, but, you know, he's typical. I say this and just go back on vacation, you know. So I know you see.
Now, we have said a lot more about Ferguson than Obama has on this podcast.
That's right. We've said more about it than he ever will.
It didn't make any sense what we said, but we got in and gave it a shot.
Somebody tried to do something, at least, yeah. Now, if you know, people upset, he ain't saying nothing, he ain't going to do nothing. And I'm just saying, you know, all you people who vote for him, now you can, and I got nothing to do with race. And I got nothing to do with race, because as I said, like, black people mad at him now. So all these people are finally seeing his true colors, which ain't black, it's just, you know, awful color, whatever it is.
Like a mustard yellow?
I don't know, like a burnt orange.
Those 70s colors were really awful. Like
burnt orange, that's Boehner. He already got
orange
down.
Oh, he is.
Down.
That's his color.
It's him. He got that down. But just, you know, it ain't got nothing to do with, like I said, like black people now starting to see. He don't care.
Well, I'm glad that, Jackie, that black people are finally
coming around. Yes, I say I've always liked black people. Now, people say, oh, Jackie, racist is because you don't like Obama. I love black people. I always have. It's nice to have you. Nice to come on board. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Come on aboard what?
Just, you know, not realizing what Obama's up to.
So,
not you was going to say slave ship. I wasn't saying nothing like that.
I wasn't
going to
say slave ship.
What were you going to say?
Well, now
they didn't say come on aboard on slave ship. They didn't ever say that. They didn't put them on. You always twist and turn trying to make whatever I say racist.
I have had so many opportunities on this episode to make what you said right. Just 2 minutes ago, you said, let me tell you something. Black people. And just that, I was like, oh, God. But
well,
I shut my mouth and let you plunge ahead. I just let you say that black people are smartening up. I just let you say that finally black people have got some damn sense.
I didn't say it didn't have sense. Just concerning Obama. I understand wanting to vote for Obama. I understand all that. That makes sense to me. But now it's like, well, maybe we shouldn't have. That's all I'm saying. And this ain't nobody ain't got no sense. I like all people. Let me make it clear. Not just black people. I like all people. You treat me right, I treat you right.
Which people do you like the best?
There ain't no best. It's whoever acts most decent.
Oh, and then it goes, be non-violent in the face of the violence we've been experiencing for the past 400 years is actually doing our people a disservice. In fact, it's a crime. It's a crime. And then they go, confusion. Here come the drums.
What?
I had to look it up on my phone.
I don't know what you...
From Can't Trust It.
What?
Can't Trust It.
I don't know what that is.
Wow, I did. When I was quoting that, I don't even think I realized that how appropriate that was. I thought it was just another reference. Huh. Oh, my God, what if I just killed Chuck D?
Don't say, kill anybody. I don't care who it is.
More likely it'd be Flavor Flav.
I know people
understand that.
I don't like him.
Hopefully they're both okay. Hopefully Pat Harrington is okay. Valerie Bertinelli. Dudley. Todd Bridges. All of them. Everybody we mentioned on this show.
Todd Bridges needs to watch what he says.
Todd Bridges needs to watch mouth, but yeah. I hope we have
I
not
don't
killed
want
him.
I don't want to kill, like I said. You know, there ain't no such thing as a curse. There just ain't no such thing, first off. But if it was a curse, you got to use it wisely.
That's what I wanted to test it with Valerie Bertinelli.
Why her? Why you won't kill her? But you ain't going to, number one. You ain't going to kill nobody. I'm just, because there ain't no such thing. But if there was such thing, you shouldn't say nobody's name.
Well, you have to test it. You have to know.
No, you don't. You don't have to acknowledge it outside of saying, quit saying this curses ain't real. That's the end of it. End of story. Don't say anything else. Don't try to kill nobody. Ain't nobody. Run your mouth ain't worth killing nobody. Steal cigars ain't worth killing nobody. Don't kill nobody.
Yeah, we can leave the podcast, I think, on that note. Well, it's not killing anybody.
Don't just however much you want to. Don't kill nobody.
We're not saying you can't not want to kill people.
Well, this doesn't go for soldiers. Now, soldiers, you have to do that. That's your job. It's that they ain't here. When they end up back in Iraq, when Obama sends them back.
So we should say don't kill Americans.
Don't kill. Don't matter what color they are. Don't matter where they come from.
Only their nationality.
Well, either way, if you ain't in a war with them,
right?
Don't kill nobody. Now, Ferguson look like a war, don't it? It looks awful.
I hope peace be with you, everybody. I hope everything's going okay
I go for police and all the people in the community. Don't any of y'all kill anybody. Please don't. Just don't try not to tear gas anybody either. Just hope it all works out somehow. I don't know how.
I don't.
I have a clue. I don't know what the hell they go.
Me either.
Oh, that's pitiful. Well, are we done?
Yep.
It's hot. I'm going to get out of here.
All right, let's go.
I'm sweating through my overalls now. Down in my leg ash, you know.
Why? Why are you saying this? Of course, why am I stopping you now? I should have really stopped you.
Why? I'm just saying it's like I'm sitting in a wet spot because I'm all the sweat in the...
Yeah, let me out of here, too.
I won't get out of here. Y'all, thank you for listening to Racing Reviews. Don't kill each other.
Don't kill anybody in America.
Unless you're a soldier. A real soldier not dressed up like a soldier. That's two different things. So real soldiers, real war, do your job. Do whatever your commanding officer tells you. Don't listen to me. But everybody else, just try not to kill nobody. And, yeah, Race Reviews, iTunes, Flicks. Sweaters and Bookface, all of it. Thank you. Get on there and say hi, and it's all good. Yeah.
It started in slave ships.
Slave ships. There are more records of slave ships than one would dream. It seems inconceivable until you reflect that for 200 years ships sailed carrying cargoes of slaves.
Run, none, be nonviolent. In the face of the violence that we've been experiencing for the past 400 years, is actually doing our people a disservice. In fact, it's a crime. It's a crime.
Here come the drums!
So the people give you some of that reaction to the facts that I kick in a stick, in a stay around, point to the joint,
put the booty down.
Don't get to the roots, and giving it up, so turn me loose. Then again, I got a story that's harder than a hardcore cost of the Holocaust. I'm talking about the ones still going on. I know where from that dumb billy dumb from the base motherland, the place of the drum, invaded by the whack, did it whack, it fooled the black, it left us faded. King and Chief probably had a big beef, because of that now I grit my teeth. Is gory. Little rock where they be docking this boat.
the ship's captain, getting me bruised on the cruise. While I got the loose, lost all contact, got me laying on my back, ruling in my own leftover. When I roll over, I roll over on somebody else. 90 damn days on the slave ship, counting falling
off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 100 at a time.
Blood in the wood in his mind, I'm choking off spit, feeling pain like my brain being changed. Still gotta keep it what I got, it's hot in the day, it's cold in the night. Again, bass in your face, yeah, not an 8-track, getting it good to the wood, so the people keep it some of that, reacting to the facts that I kick in a stick, and it's stay around, point to the joint, put the Buddha down, going to the roots, and giving it up, so turn me loose, then again I got a story that's harder than a hardcore cross of the Holocaust, I'm talking about the war still going on, I know where I'm from, not dumb, did they come from the base of the land, the place of the drum, invaded by the whack, did they whack, it fooled the black, it left us faded, King and Chief probably had a. Because of that, now I get my teeth. So here's a song to the strong.